what I'm going through. My mother, we used to complain about when I was little, shoes. We wanted the latest styles there. And we used to complain because she's carrying the Kmart and getting them old crazy looking shoes. But one day my mama said something to me that stuck with me all through my adult years. She said, "You complaining about shoes? What about a man that ain't got feet to use?" So it's never as bad as we think it is. But we just need to get out of our own way. Amen? Amen. Y'all may be seated in the presence. Hell be hotter than any fire known, or 10 times hotter than any fire known on earth. So if it's hot right now, and we running from AC to AC, but our life is raggedy, we may not be running from AC to AC, but we gonna end up in a place where there is no AC. If we don't get it right. Listen, Brother Devon, it's never too late to get it right.
No, it's not.
The time that when it's too late is when they got you laid out. Now you're going before what they call judgment. I was watching some, I don't even know what it was, flipping through the channels, and the people were talking. And they made a statement. They said, "God will cash in here." I said, "That bothers me. That bothers me. It's not theologically correct. Because the scripture says, beloved, I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in heaven." That's what God said. So why would God in one mouth tell you he wants you to be healthy and prosperous and have a fun and abundant and joyful life? That's what all that means in the package. And then later on say, "I'm gonna cash you in the head." What's beginning to happen is there are few that God is revealing his revealed knowledge to. He's beginning to crack open some things that man had not had access to before, because they weren't ready to listen. So we've been taught some things that is not correct. But as God begins to reveal itself, gone away to prepare you a place. If it were not so, I would not have said. And when I'm going away, I'm going to come back again to take you back with me. Is preparing you a place. If God is preparing for you, wouldn't it seem that we need to prepare for him?
Amen.
Scripture says, "I'm coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle." And he's not coming back for a single. Out of all the churches in Jacksonville, we think that scripture means he's just going to pick one church out and that's going to be the one. No, that's not what that's talking about. What that's talking about is there are people inside each and every one of these churches that are truly calling out to God for real. And those people are his church. It's not what you say you're going to do for God, but it's your actions.
That's it.
We say a lot of stuff, but what does your action say? And I want to thank the Wynn family going with me.
Woo-hoo!
Yes. Down the pastor, Reese Church. know we was in it. We could see it going, but we got the early enough to see it.
Amen.
See, he could force you to worship, and we call that angels. They, their job is to worship. But he said, I didn't want worship like that. I wanted you to choose to worship. I wanted you to choose to submit to me. Because when you choose to submit, that's a level of love that's not forced. God does not force himself on anybody. It's us that